Okay, good morning all.
Good morning, sir.
Good morning, sir.
Good morning, sir.
Okay, I'll start today's lecture. I've been looking at your assignment. I got this from group one. I haven't really looked into the content, but it seems like a professional way of arranging the information, which is good. Good, on this one chart, I see. Let's see what the other group has. Group two. Okay. This production structure. Okay, good. So it's nice. The software budget. Okay. It's quite, quite steep for project manager, but anyway. Group two, this is in your budget, you allocate about 183 million for project manager. Would you mind to elaborate that? The base of your calculation that the project manager deserve to be paid 180 million for how long? For 6 months. If you compare to group one, they only allocate about almost 70 million for a project manager, but for you, it's 180 million. Group two. Landrikus, Stephen Kenji. Would you mind to elaborate your words? Landrikus. Stefan, can you hear me? Hello.
Wait, sir, I still open my Excel first.
Okay, but you don't need the exact number, but you put a number 180 million more than 100 million just for a project manager salary. Yeah, so where did you get that number? The base for your calculation?
I get this number from the calculation in human resource. Because based on their experience and the education. Is because the based on the experience and education. So the every hours the project manager must be paid around 200,000. And because based on the working hours, I calculate it around 960 hours.
Okay, remind me again, what is your system? What is your project?
It's about the inventory management system.
Okay. Do you know how the skill of your inventory system? I mean, for the company that you are building the inventory system, how much they make in a month? I mean, what kind of company that you want to build this system?
Like a fast food company.
Fast food company. Is it for national or just local?
I think for local, I think.
Okay, local. Si project manager in Indonesia. Let me share this screen. See this? The average salary of project manager in Indonesia is just 114 million rupiah per year. So, and your company is only local fast food. How much they make? Can they make a billion a month to justify this expense? I think you need to recalculate the salary part because it's too much. Even for look, let me tell you, even for the project that I was involved, the cost of the project just for the hardware alone is $100,000. Okay, and you know the salary of the project manager is just 50 million for the whole project. Okay, so it's too much for Indonesian standard. Okay, and that's fine if your project's worth billion and billion of rupiah, but you just build inventory system for local fast food. Do you think the local fast food restaurant can afford to pay 100-something million to a project manager? I don't think their owner can get this much for himself or herself. Right? Okay, that's okay. Okay, let me see group 3. Okay, the budget is okay. Nice. I haven't seen them, but let's see the budget. So this is for equipment, operational department. Okay. Group 3. These people, human resource from IT department, finance department. This is are they currently being employed by the company? Or this is just department in your project?
Just department in the project, sir.
Okay. Okay, five is management department. Okay. Do they have different position in your project structure, or are they equal?
I think equal.
Who is the project manager?
In the management department, sir.
And, okay, so there are three manager department, project manager, or only one?
Only one.
And he or she will be paid 7 million a month, equal to other that work under the person. And you see the problem with that?
Sir. Yes, sir.
Okay, so you need to fix that. Look, it's good that you have a ballpark estimation on this kind of expenses, but you need to think of the structure of your project. Higher position will have bigger responsibility, heavier workload, and everything. So they have to serve a bigger payment. Okay, how much bigger is up to you, but if you pay project manager equal to other staff under his or her command, then it would be a disincentive for that project manager. Okay? It would, I don't think that will motivate the project manager to work better because the salary is the same, even though the responsibility is bigger. Okay?
Okay, thank you, sir.
Okay.
Now, lastly, chart, nice, check. C Senior level programmer, junior level programmer, software engineer. Okay, group four. What's the difference between programmer and software engineer?
I think the difference is in the application they use.
What application they use?
For the programmer, I think like the for the coding and software engineer like the whole application or.
If the software engineer responsible for the whole application, why did the software engineer pay the same as programmer in the senior level programmer?
We don't think about, we don't pay attention about that. So
okay, that's okay. This is my concern. Okay, that's good. Look, I'm happy with the work that you already done. You show a lot of components that need to be there on the report. About the numbers, the composition and everything, that's okay. That's why we need to review your report frequently to find out whether or not your work on the right way. And sometimes I know that it's difficult, especially for you that has never been into the system development world, to find out how much it costs or how much it's pay for certain position. But you can always Google them, you know, and a lot of people already creating a survey or research that try to find out how much it's the average salary of certain position in certain industry in Indonesia. So there are a lot of survey like that and information available on the internet. And you can use that as estimation on how much it costs for your project. And you need to remember, the whole project should not exceed the value of the company. So for example, my example earlier, if it's just local fast food restaurant, could they afford to build system that costs hundred and hundred of millions rupiah, and that just for inventory system? Okay, if I was the fast food restaurant owner, I would allocate hundred of millions rupiah to my core business, which is the fast food restaurant, not for some inventory system that probably only help a bit. Okay, so you need to consider that. Okay, remember, you're an accounting student. Every business decision in practice, in reality, should be based on cost and benefit consideration. The cost to do something, some business action, some business decision, should not exceed the benefit. Okay. That's the main guidance, rule of thumb, golden rules, or whatever you want to say to call in making business decision. Okay. Now I already gave you material about data requirements last week and today's system process requirement. I will not talk a lot about this, but I will talk about the example. Okay, like you remember, my example is about PNPM, Mandiri Perdesaan, which is the poverty, one of the poverty eradication effort by Pak SBY when he was the president of our country. Okay, so basically, what the system developer at that time did was they send people, they make some they conduct survey. Let me see if I can find the survey. So basically they did survey all over Indonesia to try to find the requirement. Okay, I'll share you this. Okay, so these are the survey report. So the developer sent teams to 12 different location, 11 different location in Indonesia. They sent teams to Yogyakarta, East Java, Banten, Lampung, Northern Sumatra, Central Kalimantan, West Kalimantan, South Sulawesi, Papua, at the time still Papua, not yet separate, divided into Papua and West Papua, Northern Sulawesi, Northern Maluku, and NTT. Okay, they also have a geographical information system survey in Northern Sulawesi. Let's see what they have in Yogyakarta. Okay. Share you the content. So this is the survey. So this is the survey report in Yogyakarta. Okay. They present the profile of Yogyakarta, the province. Okay, they find out, let me see, for example, the technological infrastructure. So this is before 2013. So if you can see, the best wireless or the best cellular service at that time was 3G. It's not yet 4G. 4G only happened in 2015. I think the survey was in 2011 or 2012. I can't remember exactly, but yeah. So it's 3G. Okay. And you can see they still have a few cellular operator that's currently non-existent anymore, like Flexi from Telkom. Okay. So this is what they did. They also goes to Gunung Kidul, Bantul, Kulon Progo, Sleman, and also they tried to test the internet connection in the city of Yogyakarta, which is at the time the download is only at 87.5 kilobit per second and upload 46.7 kilobit per second. At that time, it was decent enough. Okay, not stellar, not the best, but decent enough. Okay. Let me share the desktop so it's. Let's see the one that West Kalimantan. You can see, okay. So. That's what they did. Okay. They see the problem. Okay. So they are in Sambas Regency. They see that the internet connection is quite decent there, although the ping or the the time for the data to reach their destination is quite big, but this is okay. So they mentioned here that the cellular connection only have GPRS. This is one of the lowest part, the lowest quality standard for cellular communication. GPRS usually use for the ETC machine, electronic data capture machine, that you probably saw it in some supermarket to process payment with credit card or debit card, and it's, I don't think it is used anymore. I think now GPRS and Edge has been dismantled by the cellular operator, and it was replaced by 3G, SSDPA, or 4G. And so they also noticed that the signal in West Kalimantan, in this Sambas Regency, only capable of sending text message or making a phone call. Let's see the other example. Papua, for example. Okay. And they have this. This is the current system that they use. I don't want to send us. So. This is one of the constraints that faced by people in Papua, which is electricity. It's often they are experiencing blackouts quite often. Yeah. And they have a old computer. Okay. They don't have scanner or GPS. Okay. And human resource in Merauke. Why? Because of the terrain of the location. Sometimes to travel from one village to other village, they between two villages in Papua, the only way to travel between villages is by foot. You have to walk, and it could take 5 days to 7 days a week traveling by foot to reach another village. That's why sometimes they use small airplane or helicopter, and that's quite expensive. So that's the report of the survey. Okay. The purpose of that survey is to find out the reality in the field, okay, and try to elucidate what's the requirement for the new system. If you build system like Gojek, for example, or Grab, or any other mobile-based application at that time, and you find out that in West Kalimantan there are no good or sufficient quality cellular service for those kind of application, then deploying or using that application in West Kalimantan would be useless. If you find out in Papua they have difficulties with electricity, real-time system that work 24 hours is out of question, because you cannot guarantee there will be electricity available in Papua. Remember, this survey was conducted about 7 or 8 years ago. Okay, so it's almost a decade. Currently, they're probably they have better infrastructure, but I don't think within the rural area, you know, deep in the forest or in the jungle, there will be any differences, because probably electricity hasn't reached that yet, but they still have villages on the very remote area. Okay, so that's the problem. Okay, so now how to present, if you like, the requirement. So okay, so this is the final report. Okay, the final IT master plan. So the date is 2013. Okay. For BNPL Mandiri Perdesaan. Okay. They start by mapping the process. So when you want to build a system, first you need to find out one. The first thing that you need to find out is what kind of decision being made in that system. For example, inventory. Kenji, you there? Stephen Kenji?
Yeah, yes, sir.
Okay. So, in your proposed system, inventory, right?
Yep.
What kind of decision being made relating to inventory in your case? What's the inventory information will be used for?
I think it will be used for the owner to know the left inventory. Mm-hmm. So when they want to accept a massive order, for example, mm-hmm. they will know if their left inventory is sufficient enough or not.
Okay, good. Any other information that you want to that you need from the inventory?
I think it will help the owner as well to like manage the inventory per month and uh-huh. knowing how much item they need to okay. buy for the next month.
Okay, okay. That's all? Is there any other information that can be drawn from inventory information?
I think that's the main purpose.
Okay. How about the cost or the value of inventory? You know, it's fast food, it's fast moving, and prices are changing every day. You probably buying egg 15,000 rupiah per kilo today, and next week it could be 14,000 rupiah per day. So you need this information, the value, the monetary value of your inventory, to determine the cost, especially like you said, if this company will receive special order. Yeah. they probably have a fixed price for menu in their restaurant, but in case somebody have special occasion and order special menu, the owner can calculate the price. They probably could give a special discount, for example, or they could offer a specific menu that not available on the restaurant, and they require the information from the inventory, which is the value of the inventory. Okay? Moving on. So, the first thing that they need to know, if you want to determine the requirements, either data or process, is to understand the process and how decision was made in the organization. For example, this one. This is the common process in BNPM Mandiri Perdesaan. The process has been fixed. I mean, the process has been developed by the government of Indonesia So the system just need to accommodate this process. For example, it start by this part. You can see this. Can you see my screen? Can you see the diagram?
Yes.
Okay, good. So it start by, I'm sorry, this is in Indonesian language because it's official report to the government of Indonesia. So it's there by knowledge and indicator. So when the government want to create some program, they need to set a standard on how to evaluate the result. Okay. So for example, if you want to health seminar, you need to set a standard on what constitute as successful seminar. How many people should attend that seminar, things like that. Okay, so they set out this. And then based on the citizen of the village and also the social condition, they will create planning, the program planning, not system planning. So this is the program planning. Okay. There are many programs within the poverty eradication effort by SPA at the time. There are generasi, this is for the children, you know, giving them extra food, giving them extra nutrition, giving them immunization, vaccination, medication, tuition fee, things like that. The normal PNPM, which is helping the village to build or to get something like training or any infrastructure. There are RLF. RLF is, I can't remember what's the exact RLF stands for, but that's for giving loan. Oh, this revolving loan fund. So the government provide funding, and then the village will create a group, and then the member of the group can borrow the money, okay, and then every month they will repay the loan with small interest, very very small interest, okay, and then after they pay the loan, the fund can be borrowed by other members. So that's called that's why it's revolving. It's just like the system is just like arisan, if you know how arisan works. Okay, and then there is optimization. Then there will be funding. The government send give the money for the activities, and then this is the execution of the plan here. If they want some training, they'll get training. If they want to build something, they'll get the money. They'll have the procurement. They'll finish the project. If there is some fraud, there will be punishment. Okay. And then there will be monitoring of the result by the government and also the World Bank. There will be audit. Somebody. The whistleblower, you know, give the information about some fraud or any other crime that happening. The village government, the head of the village, the secretary, you know, there will be evaluation on the people who receive the benefit. If the student here, for example, receiving extra nutrition, they will be checked whether or not they actually receiving the extra nutrition, or what kind of nutrition they get, you know, did they get vitamin A, did they get extra snack, or did they get immunization, things like that. And also maintenance, like road maintenance, facility maintenance, things like that. After finish, then the lesson learned from the whole year will be used to develop the new knowledge and indicator for next year, and the process will continue. So this is the basic process for PNPM. Okay, based on this, then they develop the system. Based on that, if you look at the business process, on each big bubble here, there will be information requirement. For example, for knowledge and indicator, they need information from previous year. Okay, reporting, audit, any complaint, list of asset, list of maintenance, people who receive the benefit. Why it's important, for example? Why the receiver of the benefit important? Because they receive the benefit because of their status as poor. Okay, they considered poor, so they will receive benefit. But if they were no longer categorized as poor, they are no longer entitled to that benefit. So that will be updated here in knowledge and indicator. Or for some reason they move away from that village. Okay, probably go to somewhere else to pursue better life. That's fine. That's normal. But they can no longer listed as the receiver of benefit in that specific village or area. Okay, they will be somebody else's problem, not that village. That's why it's need that information. The audit report will be used again here in knowledge and indicator to develop better system, better process next time. Okay, so each step in this process will require different information. Now, what you need to do with your project is to identify this process. For example, let me see your project. Let's see, for example, group 3. Okay. Okay, group 3. Okay, oh good. What kind of remind me again, what kind of system you want to build, group 3? Maria Ignacia and Giovan.
Payroll system.
Okay, payroll system. Good. Now, with payroll system, you need to lay out the payroll process. Okay. How the payroll process started. You need to map that process first. And then for each step of parallel process, you need to find what kind of information required. For example, will you calculate the attendance for payroll? Or did attendance of each employee will affect payroll? What kind of company is this? Giovan.
It's transportation.
Okay.
Business.
Okay. What kind of transportation?
It can be motorcycle or car.
Okay. Also, it's like. Is it taxi or rental or what?
What, sir? The last is.
Okay. It's rental. Okay, okay, good, good. So what's the base for the base for your salary calculation? Order received, order completed, kilometers reached, or something else?
So we calculate the what is the measurement, use the kilometer, but we give to the mitra on the driver is based on per transaction.
Okay, so can you give me one example? So I receive one order to deliver. Okay, go on.
Okay. Because this example is like in the Yogyakarta, so we measure the tariff per kilometer used based on the UMR, and then the example is 1 kilometer is 3,000 or 4,000, and then the driver receive order is for 3 kilometer, so it will be 12,000, right? And then after they complete the order, so the driver will get the 70% of the fee of that.
Okay, good. Now that you mentioned, this is quite interesting that you mentioned about the minimum wage. Okay. You need to, if you want to go to, I mean, if you want to build a payroll system, then you need to understand the law regarding payment of salary. Because if I'm not mistaken, it's been few years, many years ago that I last involved with payroll system. But there is a government regulation on when the salary should be paid the latest. And obviously there will be special bonuses for holiday, THR. There will be provision for insurance, health insurance, BPJS kesehatan, and also BPJS ketenagakerjaan. Okay. There will be any other. There will be tax. Okay. Income tax. You need to understand. And there is a minimum wage. Okay. So you need to put aside, what if a driver in a month, because I don't know, the driver is lazy or something, like couldn't at the minimum wage amount. So what would happen? Because if you pay somebody under the minimum wage, this is my understanding, I probably mistaken, you'll have problem with the government. Okay, company that pay under minimum wage in normal condition will be punished by the government. Okay, I don't know the status of companies like Gojek or Grab. Is the driver considered as employee or something like that? I don't know. That's beyond my understanding. But you need to research into that. Okay, and you need to put that into your you need to understand the regulation. Okay?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Okay, good. Okay, let's continue. Questions. Okay, so again, and it's you create the requirement from there. Okay, so we'll see, I will show you the requirement. Let me see if I can find. So this is the proposed business process. Okay, if you can see, I'll just one that I shown you. So and they lay out the process flow. Okay. And if you look at this, you don't need to build this, but this is some kind of they show you the form. Okay. Again, the documents, information that they need. You don't need to do this. It's just an examples. Okay, because it's quite elaborate and plenty of things that need to be put into. Okay. Okay. So it's just examples on how to create a diagram to show the process and also the information requirement. Okay. What you need to do? I will not give you any assignment today, not formal assignment that you need to submit anyway, but I will give you the formal assignment will be given next week for replacing the midterm exam. Okay, so what you need to do now is to make a list of information required by your system. Like I said, identify the process, on each step of the process, identify the information requirement. Okay, what kind of information needed, what for what purposes, like for example in the inventory, for example, to find out the level of the inventory. Okay, and then if the owner know the level of the inventory, what kind of decision that can be made? So make that list. Okay, and then after you make a list of the information requirement and also you need to identify the process, you need to find out where the source of that information. Okay, for example, in salary. Okay, in payroll, like group three examples. Kevin was telling me that you guys calculated the salary based on the kilometers total that has been done by the driver. Okay, that information coming from, how do you know how many kilometers has been traveling for order or many orders in a day? So you need to identify the source of information. Another examples, if you want to know if you want to create a payroll system again, and you want to know where did the company knows if an employee has been absent or not, where the information coming from. Okay, in Atmajaya, for example, is from the, it used to be from the fingerprints system. You also have that. Okay, so where did the faculty decided whether or not a student's can attend final exam based on 75%. That's the information required, whether or not a student attend the whole class, total class, at least 75%. Where did the faculty find that out? From the fingerprints system. Okay, so the student need to check in and check out. Okay, so that's example. Okay, so I need you to create that list. Okay, what kind of information needed on each step of the process, and where the information comes from. Okay, and then next week I need you to present that to the class. Okay, it's not a submission, it's not a progress report. I just want you to present that next week. Okay, any question? Any anything need to be clarified or discussed? Arya, Evangeline, Giovan, Landrikus, Livia, Maria Ignacia, Stefan Gaji. Okay, so clear what you need to do for next week? Oh, okay, good. So make a list. What kind of information required? Where that information coming from? Okay. And then we'll discuss that next week. Okay. If that's all, okay, that's all for today. So I suggest you to discuss with your group what kind of information. I don't need complete that. I just need some list that we present that next week. And if there's no, I'll stop the lecture now and see you next week.
Okay, thank you, sir.